Well, my next guest says President Obama's decision to delay the Keystone XL pipeline project until after the election shows an abject failure to put jobs ahead of politics. That pipeline would end in Congressman Ted Poe's Texas district. He joins us tonight from Capitol Hill. Congressman, good to have you with us. I mean, just about the time I was applauding the state of Nebraska and Trans-Canada Pipeline because they were accommodating environmental concerns, willing to move the pipeline wherever in order to meet the objections of the environmentalists, the Secretary of State decided that they wouldn't speed up their decision-making by one whit. What the heck's going on here?
That's exactly what took place. After the pipeline was postponed, the decision to build it until 2013, TransCanada and the folks in Nebraska who had the issue with the environmental issue decided to reroute it. They agreed, but the State Department said, not so fast. We're still not going to make a decision until 2013. And the problem this creates is that pipeline's going to be built. The Canadians will build it, but they may not build it that goes all the way to Port Arthur, Texas, in my district on the Gulf Coast. They're going to build it to the west where they can offload that crude oil into Chinese tankers, and that oil is going to go to China.
And Stephen Harper, the prime minister, making no bones about it. And the arrogance of the administration to simply say, send your oil wherever you want. There's no strategic interest on the part of the United States. We have no obligation to be good partners on energy policy, and we have no interest. Even though the president's given all sorts of speeches about reducing our dependency on Middle East oil. None of this squares up.
It doesn't. And Canada is an ally. They're a stable country, not like some of the Middle Eastern countries. This oil, 700,000 barrels a day, is about as much as we get from Venezuela. By the time it's fully completed, the pipeline, it'll be about as much oil as we get from Saudi Arabia. And it would seem like we would want these jobs, the construction jobs created in the United States, the refinery jobs created in the United States, and make us a situation that's good for America, good for Canada. But it is also a strategic decision that should be made now, not in 2013.
The president's made it very clear he's voting present and he's going to stay present in that decision throughout 2012. Is there anything you and the Republican Party can do to change his mind?
Well, we've already started working, even in a bipartisan way, to ask the president to have the State Department make a decision. They don't need to wait till 2013. They can make that decision. This has been going on since 2008, just making the decision. So it's time, as I like to say, to pick a horse and ride it. Pick the horse for energy independence from Middle Eastern oil. Okay. Make the decision, and we'll push the president and ask him to reconsider this decision.
And there is no disguising the reality here. This is President Obama's decision, no one else's. He is the one deferring the decision, and as a number of people have pointed out, the president. Congressman Ted Poe, thanks for being with us. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Lou.
Up next,